Hey folks, this is Shanosis, and as promised, today I'm going to show you a step-by-step guide of how I built my own American apple tree backyard orchard here in Jamaica. Now, for this project, I've selected between 8 to 9 trees, ranging from 5 to 6 feet tall. Most of these trees that you're observing are between 6 months to 1 year old. Here's a quick rundown of all the tools and parts you need for this project. Hey, remember to show your support by smashing that like and subscribe button. Now, this is going to be the toughest part. I'm going to dig a few holes along a straight line. I think for this project, I'm going to go 2x2. Now, after all of that, I'm going to align all trees to their respective holes. I'm just going to add a little bit of water to dampen the soil. Hey, if you made it this far in the video, please smash that like and subscribe button. It really helps a lot. Okay, so now I'm going to set up my support system with the steel cable. By the way, depending on the height of your tree, you can install multiple support systems. I'm going to use a clamp loop sleeve to make a knot for crimping. Here's a perfect example. I'm going to work with this height. About 1.5 feet. This will be my main support from my irrigation line. I'm going to use the same method for the other end. However, I'm going to make an additional loop. For my hook eye tensioner, here's a full view of my tensioner. You can pause the video if you want to see it a little bit more better. very tight. Hey, if you learned something new, remember to smash that like and subscribe button. Thanks. Now I'm going to align the irrigation hose on the tension wire. To avoid bending the irrigation line, I'm going to install an elbow lock. As you can observe, that's a perfect alignment. To stabilize the irrigation line against the post, I'm going to apply a zip tie. Now it's time to connect the main line. I really like these elbow locks because they are very secure. Now it's time to remove the excessive irrigation line, and then I'm going to secure it with zip ties again. And remember to add your end cap. This will be used for flushing the line from any debris if necessary. Now I'm going to connect the main end to my timer. I'm currently using Orbit's Wi-Fi timer. With these timers, I'm able to monitor my irrigation systems directly from my phone. And what I like about this setup, it gives me the ability to automate my schedules for my irrigation system. By the way, I'm currently installing a quick release connection for my irrigation line. After I install my timer, I'm just going to flush the line just in case for any debris. Now it's time to transplant the apple trees. But before I do that, I'm just going to loosen the dirt a little bit around the sides. This will help the tree roots to spread. And after that, I'm just going to apply a little bit of mycorrhizal fungi. Ensure that all trees are placed on the irrigation line for support. Now it's time to install our drip emitters. I typically use a range between 6 to 9 inches from the tree. These emitters emit 1 gallon per hour. Now I'm just gonna do a little quick test, and so far, so good. Now we're in the final stages, however, I'm just going to apply a small support clamp. This ensures that the tree is protected from wind damage. Come again, wipe on me, make me focus on you. Go again.